Y'all get ready.
Yes, you get ready.
Shout out to all my tea sippers out there. We are gathered here today to sip some tea, honey. So make sure you guys have your teacups ready because you already know this tea is what? Piping hot. Hey, tea sippers. I know I'm not in my usual location. I don't have my mug. I don't have my set. I'm on the floor in my kitchen. But I'm here because I want to talk to you guys about, you know, just some things I've been going through emotionally, some struggles I've been having, and I want to just come on camera and bare my soul. I mean, hell, I'm not even wearing weave, okay? This is not a wig. This is all my shit. That's how real this is to me. So, for the longest time, I've been struggling with my gender, okay? So, I know you guys see a woman, you know, I have big tits and all that stuff, but deep inside, there's a, you know, a man trying to come out of me. And the reason why I know this, and the reason why I want to come out to you guys and let you guys know that I too am transgender, okay? One of the main reasons why I feel like I'm transgender is not only do I suffer from penis envy, okay, like I'm jealous of anything walking around this bitch with a penis. Like, seriously, like I have two boys. I'm like literally jealous because I don't have one, you know. But I suffer from penis envy, so that, you know, was like it damn near solidified it for me. On top of that, I tend to wear sweatpants a lot. Like, even when I'm like, you see how from up here it's cute and feminine. But if you look down below, let me, you know, show y'all. I got on black socks too. That's another male trait. Even when I make my videos with my set, I'm usually in sweatpants for the most part. I sleep in sweatpants. I sleep in thermal tops. Hence the picture I posted yesterday on Instagram with me in the men's thermal top from Walmart that cost $5. And I got to thinking, like, because I'm more into like wearing sweatpants around the house and men's thermal tops, that I'm really starting to feel, no, not even feel, I am transgender. And the more I thought about it, I'm like, this makes sense. Like, I have to be transgender because for you guys who've been watching my channel for any length of time, you guys know I worked in the IT field for years, okay? I was one of the few black, quote-unquote, women that worked in the field. It was mainly dominated by white males. So that alone, like, even more solidified it. Like, girl, you're transgender. You're really a man because what fucking woman, especially black woman, decides to go into IT? You know, most black women would rather just be IG models. And you decide to go do IT. So that was something else that made me feel like I was transgender, okay? And I've always been a tomboy. And, you know, it's just what it is. And I hope that nobody's offended by this video. And you really can't be offended by it because, you know, Gigi Gorgeous, who is also transgender, basically co-signed everything that Trish Paytas was saying, that she too is transgender.
When someone tells you who they are, what their label is, how they want to be identified, you have to believe that person. Trisha said, I am a transgender man, and that is exactly how I will view him.
So Gigi Gorgeous says that basically whatever, you know, Trish calls herself, whatever Trish feels, then that is what Trish is. So we're now calling Trisha him and saying that Trish is transgender. So I too would like the same treatment, okay? So because I just feel today that I'm a man stuck in a woman's body, I would like the same respect. I would like you guys to now consider me a transgender male. I'm so glad I was able to get that off my chest. That is proof of how transgenderism works. Thank you guys for watching this video. Bye. All right, you guys. So that was me mocking Trish Paytas, okay? So if you guys do not know, Trish is currently getting drugged all over social media. It's now made mainstream news, okay? And when YouTubers make mainstream news, I like to talk about their asses, okay? Just like I did James Charles and Tati Westbrook.
Hi, sisters. Hi, sisters.
Hi, sisters.
I'm coming for Trish Paytas. So she had dropped a video the other day basically telling the world, hi, I'm transgender. And in that video, she basically just gave a bunch of just bullshit hyperboles as to why she's transgender, just like I did. Her saying that she has penis envy means that she's really transgender. Her saying that, you know, she's been a tomboy, you know, she wore short hair for a while. Just a bunch of superficial bullshit she thinks makes her transgender. So, of course, the trans community was very, very upset, as were a lot of people in the LGBT community. And if you go to her video, it has a shit ton of dislikes. Now, I'll be the first to say that I'm not the trans community's favorite person because I keep it real. And I refuse to, you know, basically coddle and feed into Malik Yoba's delusional bullshit. So a lot of people in the trans community got mad because I said, if you are supposedly a straight man and you're sleeping with a trans woman, you're gay in my eyes. Even if you feel like that's not fact, that's my opinion and I stand by it. So a lot of people in the trans community, you know, coin me as transphobic, and that's cool. Y'all coin me what y'all want to coin me. I know who I am. But the thing is, regardless if you guys hate me or not, I will always stand up towards bullshit. And when I watched Trish Paytas' video, I thought it was a slap in the face to people, especially my real trans subscribers, who allow me to be me and who may not always agree with me, but they, you know, will listen to my point where I'm coming from, and we can have respectful dialogue, right? So I'm taking up for them. For the crazies, whatever.
Whatever.
But for the ones that I know have really went through stuff, and they like really went through like gender dysmorphia and really went through the surgery to like, you know, get, you know, their gender reassigned to the opposite gender, either male to female, female to male, this is a slap in the face, okay? Trish, what you have is not gender dysphoria. What you have is a big case of attention whoreism, ma'am, okay? And this is not the first time Trish has done this, okay? For her to use people's real issues like transitioning and not, you know, knowing if they fit into the male or female body, for her to use this as clickbait, to me, is bullshit and it's an insult, okay? And it's fun doing vlogs like this. Maybe I'll do more on my kitchen floor, keeping it real and shit, but I did not like what I saw. I thought that you literally clown people who are really going through things. And regardless of people agree or disagree with the whole trans movement and what, you know, transgender people or even what LGBT people are going through, regardless, they are here and they are here to stay, okay? And it's not funny when somebody tries to go out their way to do something just for clicks and views. She has a huge audience, a big, you know, fan base, and she does this all the time. This is not the first time. Back in 2017, this mop head ass chick, okay, sat here and put some kinky, you know, weave in her hair. So her hair kind of looked like mine, and said that, you know, some stylist or some makeup artist says that she has to have black ancestry in her because black women tend to have oily eyelids.
And I didn't really find anything like on like the genealogy charts. However, I got an email. Well, I'm gonna say for the email what the email said at the end of this video. So, okay, I'm gonna keep my eyes closed because that's all that matters for this next part that I'm going to show you, but I'm going to take off my glasses. My eyelids are extremely, like, dark and oily, which a lot of people have noticed, and he said that's, like, a really, like, predominant thing in, like, the African-American culture is, like, really dark, oily eyelids, and he's like, I've never seen, like, a white girl have that. I've never even seen, like, a Hispanic person have that. Like, it's really predominantly, like, black people, and he's like, and yours are, like, getting darker every time I see, like, he honestly thought I had eyeshadow and, like, a wet thing over it to make it look, and I'm just like, no. And I do have eyelash extensions, but I do wash my eyelash extensions, so I, like, inadvertently wash my eyelids, so it's not just because they're fucking greasy as fuck. Also, the discoloration in my forehead lately, a lot of people have said that, like, I went to a dermatologist, like, you know, usually, like, pregnant women get that, but I don't really see it in you. Then, this guy's friend that I know, like, not the guy I was just talking about that talked about the oily eyes, like, this other guy I know, his friend was like, oh my gosh, like, are you black? Are you, like, well, they thought I was, like, an albino black person, like, completely 100% black, which, I mean, I could be, I don't know, I wasn't there at my birth, I mean, I was there at my birth, but I don't remember it, you know what I mean? Like, I don't, understand, like, I mean, I could have been switched at birth or mixed up or adopted and, like, no one ever told me, but they said, like, this is really, like, a common feature amongst, like, African-American women is, like, the discoloration in the skin and all that stuff like that. And I was like,
now, y'all know I'm not no big, you know, makeup eyeshadow person. My name's not Jackie Ina, so I don't know the ins and outs of oily eyelids. And, you know, I don't even know if I have oily eyelids. Maybe I do. But how does having oily eyelids equate to you having black in you? Like, this woman is a professional troll, and then she likes to play victim. When she gets backlash, she plays victim, and now she's crying and saying she didn't mean to offend anyone. And, you know, this is how she feels. Trish is so full of shit. Y'all go ahead and watch some of these clips, and I'm gonna come back with the rest of my commentary.
So, in my head, I feel like I'm a transgender female to male, but also, like, a drag queen. That's kind of how I've, like, rationalized it in my head.
Trisha Paytas coming out as transgender on YouTube and making a lot of people confused. Trisha posted a 15-minute vlog talking about gender identity on Monday called I Am Transgender, Female to Male.
I want to talk about this because it's something that I actually have felt for a long time.
Now, the video is just a stream of consciousness and kind of goes all over the place. Listen to this part.
So do I think I'm transgender? Yes, 1,000%. Do I identify with my natural born gender? 1,000%. So I think that's where I'm at.
That bit had viewers asking a lot of questions and calling the video out as clickbait in the comments. Trisha's been known to post troll videos before about changing race, coming out as gay, and other things, which has led to Trisha getting canceled over and over again.
I feel like the whole internet thinks I'm about off the ledge, but I'm like, I'm right up the ledge. I'm like this way.
You always bounce back from just about anything. It's been over 10 years of YouTube. We've seen you go through so many ups, so many downs, but we always see you come back.
Yeah, that's me. I'm like a cockroach. Can't kill me.
But Trisha says this time it's not a lie.
I don't think you have to decide what gender you are. I don't think you have to announce what gender you are. I think we can be a transgender person without having the judgment of, oh, you're not trans enough, you're not transitioning enough, you're not passable, you're not undetectable, like, that kind of stuff.
And Gigi Gorgeous, who popped up earlier, says we should believe Trisha.
So on the phone with Trisha, the transgender label was confirmed, and I found out that the video was not clickbait, the video was not shock value, that Trisha is transgender, and I heard that on the phone talking to Trisha.
Yeah, Gigi, who's been super open about her own transition, called up Trisha to figure out what was really going on.
What I found out through the years, through my journey, is that being transgender is who you are. It's your soul. It's not about how you look. I firmly believe that when someone tells you who they are, what their label is, how they want to be identified, you have to believe that person. Trisha said, I am a transgender man. And that is exactly how I will view him.
I would never mock them. I would never do a disservice to myself. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? I mean, it's not like, oh, this is not the end of the world dating or whatever, but like, why would I do a disservice to myself? You know, I want to find love and I want to find happiness. Do you know how hard that is to be like, that have a video on my channel, so many people criticizing me for my title, and yes, I could change the title, and guess what, it'd probably be easier for me too, because if I ever date someone in the future, be a guy or a girl, and they see I'm transgender, guess what, I hate to say this, but a lot of people are judgmental, and they would, I've had people tell me to my face, I haven't been out with this, but I've had people tell me, oh my gosh, like, are you sure you're naturally born female and stuff like that. Like, it's just the harsh reality, and I know that's mean and it's hurtful to hear, and it's hurtful for me to hear when people would tell me like, oh my gosh, like, are you sure you're a woman? Like, there's so many people on Bumble that are trans and don't tell you and stuff. So imagine them looking me up and seeing this. Like, I have to explain it, and I'm okay to explain that, but at the same time, I'm like, maybe my life would just be easier. Let me just take the shell that I'm in. I look like a female to you. I act like a female to you. Let me just say that I'm a female. And just continue being unhappy. And honestly, that's where I'm at right now. And I'm so sorry if I offend anyone, but Jesus, to say like, are you stupid? You're offensive. And I said, this person a DM back. I've sent a lot of people DMs back. I'm like, how can you tell me who I am and what I am on the inside? Like, how can you tell me that? You haven't grown up. You haven't been with my struggles mentally.
All right, so you guys just saw her bullshit apology, which also has a bunch of dislikes. Then she tried to come on and say that she's suffering from mental illness. She's literally self-diagnosing herself on the kitchen floor. You know, this woman definitely has a lot of issues, but I just think at this point in time, you know, when is enough enough? This is the same woman who has considered herself to be a chicken nugget. Okay, she does mukbangs on the floor. Who eats on the floor? I don't know. But on top of her claiming to be a chicken nugget, she made out with her couch. On top of that, she's claimed that she's black, she's a black woman. Now she's claiming to be a man and she's claiming to be transgender. You know, if you guys don't see Trisha for what she is, I don't know what else to tell you. She claims that she's not trolling, but the fact that you called yourself a chicken nugget, a black woman, and humped a couch in less than 2 years, I would say that this is trolling big time. And the fact that somebody who's as well, I guess you could say respected, I don't know, in the trans community, I really don't watch her like that, but I know she's really popular on YouTube. The fact that Gigi Gorgeous would sit here and co-sign this fuck shit, I gotta give you the side eye, sis, okay? Because my thing is, when you're supposed to be a representation of a community, even if somebody's your friend, a real friend is gonna call out the bullshit. You're not gonna sit there and co-sign that foolishness. You know damn well Trish does not see herself as a man. You know damn well Trish does not have gender dysphoria. You know damn well Trish is not a transgender man, but you're sitting here trying to co-sign and say whatever Trish feels, then Trish is. So if we're gonna play this game of whatever you feel, you are, then why is it that I cannot come on here and say I feel like I'm a white woman named Becky, okay? There's a white woman inside of me. I feel like I'm a white woman, you know, because whatever, I have good credit. We know most people with good credit tend to be white. Well, I have A1 credit. So that alone should make me be able to change my race and become a white woman. People would clown me. I'd be called a coon. I'd be told to shut the fuck up. Even if I was to come and say, you know, I have, you know, my great, 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 whatever, grandpa, grandma was white. So I, you know, I want to, you know, associate with that white blood. I'd be called a self-hating coon and a bed wench. But you have somebody who's transgender who's literally co-signing Trish Paytas' bullshit. And I think that's really unfortunate because it cheapens the movement and it makes people really going through gender dysmorphia, which is a real thing. It makes it look like a joke. And when you're trying to do things like that for clicks and views, I can't stand with that. I think, you know, it's just a bit much. It's funny that when she was trying to do the whole video talking about she feels like she's a black woman, she didn't get as much backlash from the black community because I think most black folks don't even watch her. I don't. You know, we don't pay her any mind like that. But you know, you cannot come against the LGBT community because they will come for your head. So now they've come for her head and she's crying and trying to backtrack and pussy pop. You know what I'm saying? And it's not working. People are not buying her bullshit. But again, you know, because she's a popular white YouTuber, she'll be okay. She'll be, you know, she'll continue to make videos on her floor, eating peas and shit, you know what I mean? And she'll continue to be popular and gain probably even more subscribers because they can always do shit on this platform to offend people, to be disrespectful, and they get rewarded for it. But there's been so many black channels just simply stating your opinion may get your channel shut down, you know? So it's really sad that Trish continues to perpetuate bullshit. She continues to be a professional troll, but yet and still, she's continuously pushed through the YouTube algorithm. So this whole situation is crazy. I just wanted to come on here and state my opinion because a few of you guys wanted to know what I thought about this and the fact that it had hit national news. I wanted to come on and talk about it. So it was fun vlogging on my kitchen floor. Even though my ass hurts, it was pretty fun vlogging on the floor. So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popping. Go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts on this entire messy situation once again concerning Trish Paytas. Basically sitting here coming out to the world as transgender, and then once she gets backlash, all the sudden now it's all, woe is me, I have mental illness, I'm just going through some things. This woman is literally nuttier than squirrel shit. Yeah, I said it, okay? She's batty as a damn bed bug. And she's a few eggs short of a dozen if you get my damn drift, okay? So anyways, y'all, let's go ahead and get the discussion popped. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to thumbs up. And most importantly, hit that notification bell so you can be down with the notification squad. Let me know your thoughts on this entire crazy situation. Go ahead and leave a comment. All right, deuces.